I guess so. I'm going to be talking about this love metric act. But before I talk about that, I'm just going to mention the project I was working on immediately before this. It's a tool to compare life insurance quotes online. It was actually my first time using Redux, and I'm pretty happy with it. But one of the main criticisms that some people gave is that the form you've got to fill in to reach this is quite long. There's a lot of information you've got to enter, and there's a lot of help text here you've got to enter. And if you're doing it for two people, you know, you've got to enter even more. So my next project after this one was to create a tool to help beginners decide how to invest their money. Now it's kind of aimed at people new to investing. So like they've got money to invest, but they don't really know what they should be doing with it. And that's quite challenging because there's a lot of information to get across and there's a lot of questions to ask. Like if it was all on one page, it'd be massive. We briefly experimented with sort of having one page after the other and swiping, but that didn't work. So what I wanted to do was have present everything in one 2D plane, so the user knows where they are and where they're going. So that is how I came up with the idea for this. So I'll zoom back over to the end so you can see. So all of these nodes represent all information bubbles or questions for the user. And sort of slowly, you start here and it slowly guides you through the process of giving you an answer of what you should do with your money. So I'll just show an example. This is just explaining how to use it. Click the next button, hands across to the next one. It's asking, what are you saving for, let's say retirement? How old are you? I'm 25. And then, let's say, there's more information than we want to fit in just this small box. So we also have modals. So if you want to go off and read like a really long guide on investment risk, you can do that. And so on and so forth. I won't go through the entire flow. And if you want to try this, it is, we've kind of done a soft launch. We haven't started publicizing it yet, but it is online on the sale, and it's on the meetup group. So I'll just briefly talk about a few points, a few technical implementation details. The actual, I guess this is probably going to be a bit small. Actually, no one can see this on that screen. So the zooming is done by animating the viewbox attributes on parent SVG. So all of these nodes and edges are SVG elements rendered with React, and they're all placed inside an SVG elements, you know, the SVG tag elements, also rendered with React. And to zoom in, it changes the viewbox attribute on that SVG, so it starts out showing the whole thing, and it shrinks down and sort of goes to one, and then it pans across, and so on and so forth. So the actual animations is done by storing a single parameter in the Redux state. So it's just a preening parameter. It starts off at 0 when the animation starts and then slowly goes to 1. And then that is accepted by multiple components and sort of used to tween the actual things that run the element. So when I'm zooming in here, they start off as circles, but you'll see they sort of slowly morph into rectangles. And that's just done by this particular element accepting the queen parameter and saying starting as a circle queen to a rectangle. So the way this is implemented, it's really rendering literally the entire app, every single request animation frame, which can be a bit slow. Because there's quite a lot of elements here. It's not really feasible to, you're not going to get a smooth frame rate if you're not doing something. So that is, so most of these components, they are stateless functional components, like we saw in the previous talk. But you can't actually use the should component update methods on stateless functional components. There's no way to do it currently. And so what I've done for basically every component is this. Can you see this?
Mm-hmm.
Right, so every component before it's exported is just wrapped in this stateless hack function. And what that does essentially is, you can see on the other screen, it constructs a new React class and uses that function to actually do the rendering, but also adds on the should component update function, which simply does a shallow equal of previous props and the next props. And of course, this does rely on in the Redux reducers, all state updates are done. I think it's using the React add-on updates helper. So it, whenever you have to change top level objects, it will give you new reference stuff. But we can talk a lot more about it. I guess one final thing I'll mention is that the algorithm to lay these out. It's currently, these are represented as a big JSON file, and just all the nodes, their inputs, and the connections to the next ones. So what it does is it just starts at the top left, does a random walk, placing down new ones, and then it uses a force graph layout algorithm, which basically simulates the physical system where there's a spring force attracting nodes where there's a link, and then there's also an electrostatic force repelling them from every other node, just sort of like reach an equilibrium where everything is stable and also close to the ones that it's linking to. And I also found that just doing that, they tended to end up in kind of a straight line, okay, from one end of the screen to the other, and it wasn't very pretty, so there's also kind of a very weak spring force just between every node and every other node, just sort of bringing everything together. And also, we also repurposed it for this other one. This is to kind of calculate your financial wellness score. So it's much simpler, but same basic idea. So any questions or comments, then talk to me afterwards. So yeah.